Hello everyone, Jeff Eccles here with The Lonely Vine, here to taste some wine. And before I get to it, I have to say I am pumped, I am excited. There's been a lot of commenting going on the TLV site, and that makes me uber happy. So thank you to everybody out there that has been commenting. I'm working on shows that people have been asking for. I'm working on getting the wines in for them, and I hope you're enjoying chatting with me in the comment section. I love it. So now, I think it's been a while since I've done a blind tasting. I really can't remember, but I think it's time to do it. So let's see what we've got going on. Get all the information out there. You can see it is the thinner bottle. So that may tell us something about what we're looking at. How you doing? How's everybody doing tonight? Having a good night? Why don't you, as I go through this, as I talk about what I see, what I smell, what I taste, make some mental notes on what you think is going on here. Have a little virtual tasting with me. And then in the comment section, let me know what you thought, if you were dead on, if you thought I was way off, or whatever. Okay, so visually, I most likely can't see it. I don't know why I always do this, but I do. Very transparent, very light in color, very easy to see through. I could get some paper and I could read it to you through here. So that tells us something, probably a thin-skinned grape. There's no real staining on the glass or anything like that. So we've got some ideas already. Let's see what the nose will tell us. It tells us there's some funk. There's some earth, there's some dirt, there's some funk going on here. Not bad funk, good funk. Definitely get some earthiness. Definitely get, there's like a little bit of mushroom there. A little bit of forest floor. You know, there's even, there's some tomato leaf in this one. Fruit wise, we're looking at the redder fruits. There's some strawberry, there's some cranberry, but mostly this is a earth-driven nose. Yeah. I got some good ideas on what this might be in this noggin. All right, palate time. Let's taste this one up. I am excited. What do you think it is so far? You got any ideas? It's not Chardonnay. Wow. Wow. Okay, so there's definitely some of that cranberry coming through. There's definitely some of that strawberry coming through. There's that earth is coming through as well. I'm getting some of those earthy kind of notes to it. There's a beautiful acidity to this. There's a beautiful finish to this, and overall, this is an incredibly well-balanced wine. Yeah, there's definitely this nice little tartness in the front. There's a little bit of smoke that's kind of coming through in there. That earth is there. I am liking this wine, I can't tell. Okay, but to stay on point, with it being a thinner looking wine, some of the things that came through on that nose, especially like the tomato leaf, some of the strawberry, some of the earth, and what came through on the palate, And the bottle too. I mean, I'm saying this is Pinot Noir. Not even going to go anywhere else. Not even going to give it maybe. I'm saying this is Pinot Noir. It's definitely, I'm saying it's old world. So I'm saying this is French. And if I'm saying it's Pinot, I'm saying it's French. I'm saying it's Burgundy. Oh, do I want to go any more than that? You know, it's red, so there's a pretty good chance it's a Côte d'Or. Can say that. I don't think I want to go any more than that. Year-wise, you know, it's tough with those, but I think it's so good. You know, so I'm looking at 2009, 2010 kind of vintage, because they were some good ones. Okay, so there we have it. That's what I'm saying. Now, it's probably going to be like Australia or something like that. No, I don't think so. But let's see what we got. The unveil. Sacre bleu! It is a Pinot Noir. It is a 2009. It is Burgundy. And it is a Devry-Tambertin. So, wow. The Clos Prieur. DuPont Trisondat. Oh, now I just birded that. I apologize. I'm pretty happy with that one. I'm pretty happy with how I did. I'm more happy with the bottle of wine that I'm about to drink. So, I'm not going to lie. Okay. I'm going to keep it short because my last video was a little long. Or I guess it wasn't. Two videos were long. The last one was the hockey skate bottle fun happy time thing. So, question for the show is, what did you think it was as I was going through the sight, the nose, the palate? What was in your mind that I was describing to you? That's what I want to know. I think that should do it. Until next time, everybody, and I am going to enjoy this bottle. Cheers.